Hey everybody, welcome to our stream tonight. Tonight we're going to work on some, or finish up a commission artwork that I started last week. I've worked on it off and on throughout the week, but before that I wanted to give you a little bit of an overview of some of the products that we have in our shop. We are Marching Band-imals. We primarily focus on marching band and music-themed merchandise in our shop. We currently have three card games, Marching Band-imals, the Fight Song, and this, what I'm showing to you tonight, is our marching band deck. It is a marching band-themed poker deck. It comes in this nice glossy blue box with different symbols on the side. And then inside the deck, let me show you the deck. Each of the backs of the cards have musical notes and symbols and some scales around the edges and arpeggios. And then if you want to look at the cards, each of the face cards are music themed. So the spade has a treble clef, and then each of the face cards has a different animal and instrument. So our spades, I've got representing the woodwind. So we've got a clarinet, a flute, and a saxophone, all in dogs. Then for the clubs, we've got cut time. And then on our face cards, we have bears for percussion. So we've got a black bear, a panda bear, and a brown bear. Then for hearts, we have a bass clef. And this section is the color guard. So they're all represented by horses and unicorns. So you got a rifle, a flag, and a saber. And then the last one, the diamonds, is a glissando, because it was the only thing I could find that would really fit in that graphic. And then our face cards are brass. So they're all llamas. And so we've got the mellophone, the trumpet, and the trombone. And then we also have joker cards that are unicorn drum major. And that's pretty much it. That's our marching band themed poker deck. And they are available in our shop. That's shop.marchingbandimals.com. They are $15. Right now, we are doing a sale for the summer where any order over $5 gets free shipping. We currently ship to anywhere inside the U.S. and most U.S. territories. Unfortunately, we are not currently shipping outside of the U.S., but that's our marching band deck. And then I wanted to just show you a couple of the stickers that we also have in our shop. So we've got this Sun drum major. We've got this Let's Band Together sticker. We have our Musophone sticker. We have our Can We Have a 5-Minute Water Break sticker, which is probably one of our most popular stickers. We have our Liar sticker. We have our Is Your Band Ready? We have There Are No Bench Warmers in Marching Band. We have I Live for Band Camp. We have our Fight Song sticker. And we have this one, we call this the I'm Dead sticker. It's basically just a baritone player laying dead in the grass, or pretending to be dead in the grass after a hard marching band experience. And then we have our holographic Marching Band-imals logo sticker. All of these stickers are vinyl. They are good to put on any surface. They are water resistant. They can be put on your car. They can be put on your phone, your laptop, your water bottle, and under normal wear and tear, they should not come off. I don't recommend putting them on your water bottle and then putting them in the dishwasher, but hand washing, they should withstand pretty well. But that's some of our merchandise I wanted to show you before I started my drawing stream. So give me just a second to transition over into my Photoshop tablet, and I will be right back. Okay, everybody. Everybody had a good week. So this is some art that I started last week. Last week we did, or I did just the line art, so let me show you just the line art on that one, if I can find it. This one right here. Yeah, now on with the show, exactly. So this is the line art that we did last week. Oh, it's hard to see with all the other layers. I hide all of the other layers so you can see it. So that was the line art we did last week. And I've spent a lot of time this week filling in the line art. Spent a lot more time on it than I really expected it to take. I am not good with this lineless drawing style that I tried to go with here, but I mean, it's pretty good considering I don't normally do people, and people are definitely not my forte by any stretch of the imagination. We're going to try to finish this up tonight and see, hopefully I can get it done tonight, because we have another one scheduled that I need to do as well. And I'd like to get started on that one soon as well. So let me turn off the music because it's really loud. I will say that I appreciate that. I'm glad that you like it, because I guess that's really all that matters. I mean, I sit and I critique it constantly because I'm the one who's looking at it and trying to fix all the little issues that I see with it. But I know I'm probably a little more overcritical of it than what anybody else would probably be. But thank you. So I've gotten most everything done on her except for filling in the tools in her tool bag. I haven't really put the glow to the tips of her antenna either, and I haven't started at all on the toolbox. So the things I'm going to work on, I'm going to try to get all of the tools done in her tool belt and then at least get started. Hopefully get almost finished with the toolbox. I don't think the toolbox will be too hard, since there shouldn't be a whole lot of pattern and textures that I have to do on it. Next time I will just lie then. I don't like to lie. I don't like to pretend like I know something that I don't. So it's kind of hard to tell when I'm zoomed out, but I tried to put some little textures in the leather straps as well. I really liked this little cubed pattern on the tool bag, but unfortunately it's kind of hard to see when you zoom out very far. But it is there. It's just a little hard to see. Now I did not hand draw the what's this thing called? I can't think. Belt buckle. I'm tired. I had to get up really early this morning. But I did draw on the seal on her shoulder from, based off of the belt buckle. And it's kind of hard to tell from a distance that I also put an earring on her, and it's just 5 screws together. So, I finished the boots. I didn't put a whole lot of detail in the boots, because, quite frankly, I was getting tired when I finished them. So I might go back and do a little extra detailing it. I did try to put the stitches in the gloves that I put on her. I might try to go back and do that as well on the boots. But for right now, I think I'm just going to focus tonight on getting the tools in the belt. So here are my lines. So those are basically the tools that I'm going to try to work with. Got to figure out which layer I need to be working on. I forgot to name my layer, so I don't know what the layers are called. I should have named my layers. Okay, there's that one. There it is. Okay, so I need to go onto above this layer. Get a new layer in there. And let's see what we can do here. So, most of the tools are like wrenches and screwdrivers because that's really the only thing I could think of how to draw. This little one right here was supposed to be like a rubber hammer, but it doesn't really look like a rubber hammer. So, we'll try to figure out something else to put there. But let me see. Most everything's probably going to be like a silvery color. Blue. That color. That'll be a good color to start with. So I'm just going to start drawing in some of these wrenches. I'm just going to, basically what I'm doing is I'm just drawing in the outlines with the lines on the page, and then I'm taking the lines off of the page and then filling it in with the details and making it a little more presentable, because the lines were just kind of thrown together just to kind of get an idea as to what I wanted to do. So we'll put those there. I think the screwdrivers are going to be a color. These were just supposed to be like wires hanging out of her bag. Then the hammer up here. I'm really glad that you love it. I hope that it does, it's exactly what you wanted. I probably won't even do anything with this tool right here because it's actually underneath her jacket, so you won't be able to see it. Well, I guess I could add another layer over top. We'll see. We'll get to that and see when we get to it. So let's go. This is still awfully blue. Try to get a little more gray. And any particular colors you'd like to see the screwdrivers be? Just going to do the handle of the hammer color. Let's not have a very hard brush. Just kind of draw the bottom part of this. It'll just be kind of sticking up underneath her jacket. Let's see. I'll do some bright colored screwdrivers. Red. Orange. Let's do orange. Yeah, I like to cover features so I don't have to draw them. I usually do that with hands. I usually put them in pockets or hide them behind something so that I don't have to draw them. Those hands are very hard. I struggled and struggled with this hand, and I am still not overly pleased with it. And this one, it was originally supposed to be holding a gun, and I just could not get it to work, so I just put a wrench in it and just put the gun back in the holster instead. It was just more than I thought that I could, more than I could do. I cut off more, bit off more than I could chew with that. So, let's see. Yeah, ancient techniques. Exactly. Let's go with like a green. Yeah, hands are weird, and it seems like no matter how you try to position the hand, it just doesn't look right. And I don't know. And there's weird curves to your hands. It just, it's not fun to try to draw them. But there are some artists out there who can turn out pictures of hands in no time, and I'm just not one of them. Go with different colors of screwdrivers. Maybe each one is a different color so that it's a different size, like the or flatheads and star shapes. All different colors. Okay, so that's basically what we're going to do here. So I'm going to turn off the lines, and we're going to take that weird looking stuff that I've got there, and we're going to actually make it look more like some tools. Color this in and flesh out the lines a little bit better. Get a little more round for this crescent wrench. Probably need to get a smaller. Yeah, I think that'll work. Got that crescent wrench, and then we got to run up here. I'll make this one a little bit bigger. I don't know, feet are pretty hard too. I mean, hands are pretty hard, but feet are pretty hard as well. That's why I like to draw shoes, because you don't have to actually try to figure out how to do that. Oh gosh. I don't even know how you would draw a spine. That'd be something I'd have to study for a long time before I'd even try to do that. Yeah, the skull's pretty round, though, so you can hide the skull easily with, like, hair and stuff. Unless you're talking about actually just drawing a flat-out skull. Exactly. Shirts, clothing makes drawing people significantly easier. Clothing makes drawing animals significantly easier. Because you can hide all the things that you don't really know how to draw underneath the clothing. I think I like those three colors. I think it adds a little extra color. So I'm gonna draw these in, and I'm just gonna erase the parts that I don't like. I don't know that it's gonna look right if I just leave it like this. Okay, now. I'm going to do some erasing, and then we'll try to fill in some stuff here. Figure out what size my brush is. It is way too big. That. We'll make this one a little bigger. Okay, so let's do some. I need to do some. That's still on the eraser. They're not changing. There we go. Oh, because I'm on the eraser over here. It helps if I change my tools. Okay. Okay, let's put some shading in. We'll start with this. I'll probably need to fix that hammer handle a little bit. Darker. Kind of blend in a little bit with the tool bag. But it's kind of shadow. Like that. Sorry if you can hear my son screaming in the background. Extra loud. What he's playing, he's probably playing Halo. Okay, so we've got the general shapes. We're going to add some shading, and then that will be done. Yeah, I didn't figure these would really take a whole lot of time. They should be fairly easy to draw, so I'm going to start with the things in the back. We'll start with the blue. Just get a darker blue. Some shades. Extra grips on the side. A lighter color on top. Well, we'll highlight. Okay, and then let's do this wire over here. One side of it shaded. Trace part of it. Tracer is way too big. Should work. Down through here, just make it smaller. Side. Off. It's just like a wire. Got some wires for something that she needs. Do the orange next. Darker color on here. Do like this and make it color. This detail in, and you probably won't be able to see it very well from a distance when we get zoomed out, but I'd like it to be there in case you want to zoom in on it and pull off some of the detail. Shades on these wires. Highlight. I'm just going to do this color. Don't like that. Okay, there's the orange one. Let's do the green one next. Keep forgetting to switch off my eraser. make this darker brown and kind of do some smaller. One has like colored in grooves on the sides of it. Ridge along the bottom. Didn't want to do that. Go back over that just a little. That looks weird. Brown. Okay. And we gotta move on to gray part of the tools. I need darker gray. So small. For some reason my brush is not changing. But this was going to be like a socket wrench. Little knob thing that you put the attach the wrench to. Socket thing too. It's going to be like a one of those. I guess it's kind of like a socket wrench, but it's a screwdriver. I don't know what those are called. Crescent wrenches. This is the hammer, so it's kind of got a, kind of looking at it from the back, so this is like the head. Need some darker colors. This light gray is not dark enough. A ridge shadow showing that it's got an indention on this. Darker. This darker. I have to put some shadow on the bottom of it in just a second. A little bit of a shadow on this edge. Too much. like a ridge on the inside of this. Well, ridge right here. Do that in a darker color. Edge. Go over that with a darker color. And here. Look of depth. This has to be colored in because it's a hole. I've been really kind of reluctant to do a lot of these really complicated drawings on my stream just because it is a lot of like tedious little work, and it's I'm not sure how entertaining it is for people to watch. So I am not offended if you're finding this part very boring. Okay, so I'm going to color the head of the hammer just a little bit darker. Use a slightly bigger brush. Kind of a ridge there. I'm glad you find it very calming. I find it very calming if it's like something that I've got completely drawn out and I'm just coloring it in, but where I'm doing it this way and I pretty much don't have any lines to know where to put the shades and everything, it's a little more tedious and a little more time consuming. Not quite as calming, fortunately. It's not saying I don't like doing it, it's just... It's definitely not something I want to sit down and relax at the end of the day to. Shadows on the bottoms of these. They're falling down inside the bag. Then I'm going to erase the extra shadow that I messed up on. Okay, and I think I'm going to say that that's probably good for the tool bag. I mean, when you zoom out pretty far, I mean, there's not a lot of detail you can see anyway, so I think I'm going to go with that. Unless there's something that you would really like for me to, like to see me do with what's there. I think I'm going to leave it at that. Just let me know if you would like something else. So the next thing is this toolbox. You want me to read bedtime stories? I think you want me to read bedtime stories. After my early morning this morning, I probably would fall asleep myself if I read a bedtime story. Okay, I'm gonna go. I don't want to go bright, bright red. Think we want to go more of a red. And we need another layer. Gotta figure out where I'm gonna put this. So it's gotta be under the hand. Here's where I'm wishing I had labeled my layers. Tool bag. Pants. That's her back foot. So it's gotta be above. Gonna be above this layer. Because her back foot is gonna actually be cut off just a little bit by the toolbox. Toolbox is bigger, so I can do bigger brush. Even bigger than that. Okay, so I'm gonna do the outline of the toolbox. Going to do the toolbox itself, and then I'm going to come back and put these like details in it. So I'm just going to do the bottom or the base of it. Got silver in that middle part. All of that will be silver. Our lines so that we can actually see what we're doing. Try to make these lines straight. Are there tools I can use in this app that could make straight lines for me? But just gonna try to freehand it. The sound of my glove scraping across the sound of across my tablet. It's kind of like chalk nails on chalkboard to me. I don't know if you all can hear it. No, my mic does not pick up a lot of stuff, so you probably can't, but man, when I'm trying to do long straight lines and trying to go really slow, I get a lot of drag, even with this drawing glove that I've got on. Horrible noise. It's awful. Good to see Castle of Luna decided to join us tonight. Trying to get her to join us. She's not been very receptive to the idea of joining us. I do blame you. It is your fault. You could have figured it out. She says that she can't watch my stream on her phone. Which might partly be true, but I did decrease the resolution of my stream so that she hopefully would not have that problem. Don't tell her that. She'll want a new phone. I don't want to have to buy a new phone. Okay, why can't... Oh, I'm sitting here trying to find my my paint bucket tool. Totally forgot that it's underneath the gradient tool. That's just your excuse. No. I know what it's... You don't want to... Just don't want to watch the stream. Trying to get these as straight as I possibly can so that when I could go to fill in the gray, I can just do a paint bucket fill. Luckily, that's behind her hand. I don't have to do it. Very straight line there. Okay, I think I've got my lines as straight as I am going to be able to get them. Bend this one out just a little bit further. Fill in this top. Gray. So don't like how that looks. Go back to the red. Okay, so now we have that, so we can start shading the base of the box. So we're going to do a dark color, a dark shade this side. So we've got a line. Probably isn't dark enough. And then we got a line that goes across the top. That. There are our sides. Kind of fill in some shades. A little more like a box instead of a flat. That gray. I might actually do the gray on a separate layer. Go back over it with a separate on a separate layer. This side's probably going to be dark because the light is on the other side. Dark gray or a dark red shade there. I don't know why I said gray. That side of the box. Edges. Okay, then we're going to have to shade this side as well. Actually under this lip where this gray is. Shading on the edge. Thankfully there's not a whole lot of texture that we have to do. I know the box needs to look a little more beat up, so I've got to add some dents and dings in it. Put a dark line across the bottom as well. Brush just a little bit bigger. Here. Out the shade a little bit because I don't have it blended out very well. I need a darker shade now. Go over here. Yeah, does it have a name? Is there like initials or something also that need to be like added to the side of the box? I'm gonna put a little bit of shadow under her hand. Too far because it looks like her hand is kind of floating. Kind of like that. I think that's good. And then I need some like a smaller, more pronounced line. Edges more defined. Kind of like that. Okay. Now, for some dents and dings. I'm going to take this darker color, and like on this edge right here, make a dark little like indent right there. Like it's dented there. Maybe take my eraser and erase out of there. Add some, take some color away from it. There. Dark color. Dark color. Gappy. You're thinking of red and red tools. It's the only one that I can think of that's red is Craftsman. They're red. Is there a reason for Scappy? Oh, you meant Scrappy. Okay. Oh, I didn't think about... I don't know anybody who uses Milwaukee. I've seen them in Lowe's. Craftsman's the first thing I think of because it's the cheap one that you used to be able to get at Sears. And I have a ton of those. Okay, so I'm going to put some silver. Like the paint has come off a little bit. I want to make it lighter, more. Soft round brush. I have it on eraser, that's why. I was painting in a gray and I was erasing. A little dent in the side. Paint off of this one. Some like scratches in it. Lighten, darken that up a little bit. paint off the edges. Kind of worn off. Not that color. Let's go back up. Bright red. Is that beat up enough, or do you want more, like, dents and dings in it? I'm going to go ahead and start working on middle. Oops, I'm still using red area. Okay. That. We're going to put some shading on this. A bit bigger. Darker. Bit harder point. That probably needs to have some like dents and dings in it as well. Here, there, the look of where the bottom or the rest of it. Okay, now let's move on to adding the rest of the details to it. So I am going to do those details on a new layer so I don't mess up that bottom layer. Let's see what they look like. So we're going to do this, not that color, slightly lighter red. This part. So this is, actually let's start with the darker part. So this is like the flap that flips up. I cannot draw and talk at the same time. Optic sensors are going to be connected to. That's probably going to be black, but I will do color in the dark color right now. And then we're going to draw this in a lighter color. Light shining on it. Okay, so then we've got the arms we need to do. Start them in a dark gray. They're going to be this. The bottom part is like this. Cross and interlock. Arms back here as well. Then the legs. Fold down from here. Latch here. And a latch over here. I think I'm not going to put that latch there because I think it's going to interfere with the arms. Okay. Let's get this done. This bottom part down here is going to be a very dark gray. On this black, and it's going to be like inset side toolbox. I have to add some shading to make that look like an inset. Get it even. Luckily, I can erase. So we're going to take a small red and kind of put a lip here, edge, to make it look like it's inset. Boy, I cannot draw a straight line tonight. Do the same thing up here. Put a dark gray edge. That there. Now, I thought what we would do here is put power bars. Put some buttons. This one looks weird. Okay. Scrappy it is. Do you want me to put Scrappy anywhere on the robot? Okay. Just kind of trying to give the idea that there are buttons there. Latch. We're going to do the latch in darker gray across the top there. Really dark gray. Really not dark enough. Shade it. I need darker gray. too dark up here. Not exactly how I wanted it to look, but I'm not sure how to fix it. Problem, I don't have it like curving over on the side. That's more like it. Exactly right, but I'd quit using my eraser. Keep clicking the and button the top first. Yes, I should do that latch over on that side, just to get it out of the way. Thing on the top. The flap on the top for his eyes. Bottom part first. Angled properly. Flap on top, it's not angled properly. That. Black, so there shouldn't be any need to shade it. needs to be a little bit more right there. This part in a really dark red. Small. Small. Shade it. Too much shading. Needs to be dark right there, where it pops up. I could find the right color, this color I want. So it just kind of pops up like that. Darker under here. Edge has got to be darker. And use this orange to make eyes. Maybe they should be green or white. Got eyes. I think I'm also going to zoom in on this and change some of these to green. Anyway, okay, so now let's do the arms. Make them a darker color, just so they stand out a little bit from that ridge around the body. Because I'm going to try to do edge that's kind of rounded. Parallel to that. Go ahead and color this side while I'm at it, and then I'll go back in and put the details in it. Stick out just a little bit farther. Kind of like that. Around that edge, just a little bit. Now, I'm going to take a darker color, smaller brush. Split right here. Right here on this edge. This part first.
Yeah. Drawing, I'm trying to draw it to make it look like it's got like a joint here to where it can unfold. Like an elbow. So it's going to be like a rounded joint. Round here. Oh, I see why I'm messing up. Well, it's confusing me. Here. I don't know. I know what I want to draw, but I can't figure out how to make it do what I want it to do. Basically, that's a joint, and it can open. But I'm having trouble figuring out how to draw that, so I'm going to just have to leave it the way it is, and we'll just know that that's a joint there, where it can unfold its arms. Then here we're going to have sort. Shade. The darker, but not the black. Shade this. Dark on the side. Joint. Mark along this edge. Darker there. There.
have some light. So now we just need to do that same thing on that other arm. Big. If there's anything that you see that I'm doing that you don't really like, or you would like to see me do it differently, please let me know. I feel like I'm just kind of rambling at this point. I am unfortunately not familiar with that. Can do a Google search real quick. Never played Borderlands. When it was first mentioned to me, I was thinking more along the lines of like D.Va from Overwatch, but then I realized it's probably not a mech. Okay. What you're saying? Chat go. My chat disappeared. There's so many games that I would like to play that I have never really gotten the chance to play. Got like 7 games in my room that I've been meaning to play and haven't done it. If I ever get the chance, I'll try it. I think I actually might even have it downloaded to my PS4, because I think I got it. It was available one time on...
Okay. I think I do have Borderlands downloaded because I think it was on PlayStation Plus a couple months ago. Or available for download. So I'm just going to finish these as kind of like handles then, instead of like arms. Do you mind if I just like draw a little flap where the arms could come out instead? And if I get a chance later, I can actually draw them in. Or do you want me to just completely remove these handles and just kind of draw something in? Trying to even think what Wall-E looked like. It's been so long since I watched that. Okay. Okay, you want to keep. Okay. How about if we put. Would you want to put them, like, on the side, or would you want to put them, like, on the top and it would come out of the top? How many arms? Two or four? What I could do is because the legs could be partially extended without underneath the robot, we could put them like right here. You wanted to do four arms, two on each side. Or if you wanted to just do two arms, we could like put it right there. Yeah, see, that's up to you. And a weapon arm. So maybe put the weapon arm coming out of the top. It's okay. I understand. How do you want that to look? Do you want it to just be something that comes up like from back here? Or is it something that's always there? Okay. Since I've already got her hand drawn there, how about if we just, can I just draw like the trap door where it's supposed to be and that it can pop up out of that when it's in robot mode? we do like a softer. Might be dangerous to have a robot with a laser pistol that's armed and ready at all times. Make it split down the middle, so it, like, instead of popping up like this, it opens up kind of like a two-door trapdoor. Color. I must have a racer out. I'm really bad about doing that. I'm gonna take the silver as well and kind of trim it a little bit. Kind of visible. Down a little bit. I'll take that silver as well and go along the edge of this. That. Kind of show that the places that pop up are lined. This is
Okay. So do you want me to remove the handles, or I mean, we can see what it will look like if we leave them. Just put the feet down underneath it. Them. Then we could put the trap door for the arms here. Straight. So if it folds out that way, we're going to put the silver on this side. Show that it folds out that way. We take some of the paint off just a little bit on this side. Show that it's kind of rubbed up against it. That up here too. Is that okay? For it to kind of open up right there for the arms to come out? Okay. Then the legs. So I think instead of having them fold up this way, we'll just have them extend down instead. Take this dark gray. The right brush. Take this darker gray and go along the edge. There. So there's going to be a lighter gray inner part. That part actually will like extend down. It's got a ball bearing in it on the, like this part right here has like a joint, a round joint to allow the leg to move. So it's basically just going to slide down, and then there's a slot where it's going to latch at the bottom where it would make it, give it like a round joint, like a knee, to where it can move forward and back. I was trying to figure out how I can do this easily, but I didn't have to draw a whole bunch of joints and a whole bunch of pieces. And I could show it kind of folded up and not have to figure out how to do all of that, because I don't know how to do all that. to... kind of got to draw the little foot piece. Little foot piece here. Almost done. And I think we're done. Unless there's something else you want me to change or add. Okay. I'll post it to guest Discord later. Okay, I think that's it. Oh, I forgot to do the little ball bearing on it. Okay. That's it. Unless there's anything else that you can think of that I need to add or change or whatever, that's the character that I've drawn. It is a commission for the spa nerd in the chat through a random background on it. Hope she likes it, and I'll pass it over to her later. But oh, I do need to put some little highlights on her antenna, but I'll do that later when I put it a little bit better background to it. So, but I think that's all I'm going to do tonight. The next week, I do plan on working on another similar commission, and it probably will take me a little bit longer. I don't believe I'm going to go the same route of this same art style, the kind of lineless art style. I think I'm going to go back more towards a cartoon, not really cartoony, but you know, an art style that actually has lines that you draw the line and you color inside the line. Just because it's easier and it's less time consuming. I think I probably put in about 12, 13 hours on this alone, just because I'm not used to doing this type of art style, and there were a lot of challenges for me. But it was a good learning experience. I'm not saying that I want to do all of my art pieces in this style, though. But yeah, this is it. This is what we're how this is our finished product. But I just wanted to also plug my shop as well. So we are Marching Band-imals. We are a marching band themed card game company and merchandise. We have stickers, we have card games. Anyone interested, please go to shop.marchingbandimals.com or marchingbandimals.com. We are on Instagram, we are on Twitter, although I am not very active on Twitter. And Facebook, you can follow us in any of those places. Of course, you can follow us here on Twitch as well. I have kind of gone off my normal type of drawing and doing these commissions, but I thought it would be a good thing to kind of branch out and do, because I didn't really have a whole lot of things drawings that I needed to do specifically for my Marching Band-imals account. So I just thought it would be something different, but we do have marching band merchandise. I will be posting some new merchandise to the shop soon. I'm hoping to get some t-shirts done. I know I've said that before, but I actually do have a couple t-shirt designs that I think will do well in the shop, and I'm gonna look into actually getting them printed. One is a lobster design that I did a couple weeks ago on my stream. The pictures for that are up on Instagram if you want to view that. But anyway, I hope everyone has a good night. We will stream again next Tuesday night at 8:30 p.m. Eastern, and we'll see you then. Thanks, everybody.